for the second period then. It's two each here in Whitley between the Coventry ENL Blaze and the Whitley Warriors. 3-2 on aggregate after the first game. It's now 5-4 after the second. Chris, you were saying in the break that all impartiality has gone out the window. So asking you to talk about Whitley first. What have they got to do to neutralise the ENL Blaze, do you think?
Well, they got to shut down the ENL Blaze's momentum. They got to somehow find a way to get Adam Reynolds, maybe to get one in the back of the net, because at the moment he's been extremely well neutralised by the Blaze defence, and the Blaze are just rolling on a wave of momentum at the moment following that goal from Reece McWilliams.
For the Blaze, obviously you were saying they've just got to keep this momentum going. We'll see if they can do so. First face-off is won by the Blaze, they're immediately into the zone, obviously attacking the other way for the start of the second period from right to left in the dark shirts. Here come Whitley the other way. Supported by their fans, riding the wave into the zone. Windridge tries to play it across to the back post. However, nobody can get a shot off. It's nearly tipped past Josh Nichols. Leg guard sweeps it out of the zone. And eventually, Bukas will collect that one, try and play it down the boards. Here come Whitley. Line astern. They can't control the puck, though. Nearly collected by McWilliams. He looks up as he fails to control that puck.
And that's just something letting the Blaze down again at the moment. Just that extra inch needed on the stick just to get the pass when it comes in.
Meanwhile, though, face off Whitley putting out the line of Good, Kipping and Watson, which has been so effective so far tonight. Daniel Good, Callum Watson already scoring.
It's been the deadliest line across the course of this semi-final at the moment.
We will have to point out the second goal for Whitley. Bit of a lucky ricochet off James Pease's stick as Carl Cully tried to play it across for Adam Reynolds waiting at the back post, but it doesn't matter how they go in, as long as they go in.
Well, definitely. I mean, we were saying last night that realistically, if it weren't for a lucky bounce, it would be 2-2 heading into this game.
It is 2-2 tonight, either way. And we are about 45 seconds into the second period. Face-off in the Blaze zone. It is won by the Blaze. They'll try and play the puck around the boards to get it out as quickly as they possibly can. Binyarski whistle, though. I'm not quite sure what referee Mr. Emerson saw there. Puck will go back into the Blaze zone. I think it may have left the ice there, Chris. I've got to say,
possibly.
I didn't see any infringement.
No. Again, there, the referee possibly playing a little fast and loose with the delay of game rule.
Now, Nickpin plays the puck across to Pollock. Stevenson, sorry. Stevenson lays it back for Pease. Nickpin again. Crosses from right to left, but his
offside.
Teammates go offside. They are working their way down the ice slowly, though.
Well, it's a good speed line, this, Stevenson, Nicklin and Ricky. They can all wheel, they can all pass, and they can all play that puck. And, of course, more importantly, all three of them can shoot. And we've seen them score this year, all three of them.
Ricky Binyarski getting several chances already tonight with his speed and ability to find space. We'll see if that continues in the second period. James Pease will go and collect the puck from Josh Nichols behind the net. Josh Nichols nearly leaves him in a bit of trouble. But Pease reaches out and clears the puck. Binyarski plays the puck down the ice. Icing's waved off. Flavelle in the Whitley net will just play it round the walls for one of his defencemen to clear. It's back to the neutral zone. Pollock takes the puck as he crosses the blue line. Binyarski helps his teammate out in the corner. Binyarski hacking away like the Highlander. But the puck is cleared. Nice poke check from Ryan Selwood. And finishes his hit as well. Gets a dirty look from the Warrior. Pollock can't win it. And Zajac tries to break down the ice. That'll be icing, though. Pass very wayward indeed.
But that is a deadly play that we're seeing continuously enlisted by the Whitley Warriors. These long stretch ice passes with a one spare man just sitting between the two D-men waiting that are hanging back and catching the Blaze on the break.
The line of Hobick and Pollock now out on the ice along with Gareth Owen. They've caused problems, haven't been rewarded yet so far tonight. Offside, so the Blaze can set up in their own zone again. Gareth Owen failing to control the pass. Pollock wants to pass through the middle, doesn't get it. Daniel Harris intercepts. Mahmoud steps out of defence. Icing's waved off, so Daniel Harris will go behind the net to collect that. We're already, believe it or not, 3 minutes into the second period, 17:23 remaining. As Wieniawski picked it up behind the net.
And I swear and that drum has got louder.
They have. They're definitely trying to drown us out. We're fighting against the Whitley Warriors fans and the drums. Good save, Josh Nichols, though. He's
and again,
off.
Again, Adam Reynolds finds himself in the crease.
Fighting off the shot from Bukas from the blue line. Reynolds tries to get a tip in.
Interestingly enough, I was the goal that was washed out yesterday because Reynolds was believed to be in the crease. I actually spoke to one of the photographers here this afternoon when we arrived, and he says he has photographic proof that the goal was in before Reynolds was in the crease.
You wonder whether part of that is a partisanship. It is a very partisan atmosphere up here in Whitley. We're in our luxurious Coventry position in amongst the Whitley Warriors fans. And we can barely hear ourselves. Good save, Josh Nichols again. Shot from the point. And it's free. Reynolds will shoot that one straight into Mahmoud's glove. Nichols, it's gone behind Nichols. I'm not sure how that stuck in. But it has. And the Warriors take an early lead again. With 4 minutes gone.
Blaze, their own worst enemy there. There are about three or four men in the slot area screening Josh Nichols. He couldn't see what was going on, and he just the puck just fumbled and bobbled out of his hand, and he just couldn't react quick enough.
I'm sure the shot go in. I didn't see who got the final touch for the Warriors. We'll find that out shortly. But 3 minutes 15 into the second period, and we have the same score as the final result from last night, 3-2 to Whitley. And the Warriors fans getting on Josh Nichols' back. It's Carl Collis second from the sound of it. We'll just wait for the confirmation.
And Josh Nichols just needs to ignore the Whitley fans at the moment. I mean, we saw him get a little agitated in Nottingham when those Nottingham fans were getting on his back, and I hope that this won't get on his nerves.
Can be a very hostile rink, this place. Back in the glory days of the Warriors, there were 4,000 passionate Geordies roaring their team on.
There'd have been no room for us here today if that was the case today.
And that drum starts up again. And now I can hear it in my headphones, I'm sure you can hear it. Watson goes down the far side, tries to feed the puck behind the net to Reynolds, doesn't manage to. Puck will travel down the ice, Bidjarski will chase. But the Warriors will clear. Watson goes all the way back into his own zone to get it. Now it's with Paps. Crossover pass eventually finds Wieniawski again. Hubbock shoots, and that's blocked. Wieniawski tries to pick one up, doesn't manage to. And briefly, if the Warriors can find him, here comes Daniel Good through the middle. Blaze fans trying to rally their team. We saw the pattern in the first period, an early goal for the Whitley Warriors. Two of them, in fact, and the Blaze battle back. We'll see if we can do that again. Nicklin shoots, goes over Flavel's glove, but unfortunately over the net as well. And the heckling goes back and forth between the fans in front of us. Kieran Papps doesn't expect the puck to stop, but it does. That puck will travel down the ice. Flavel should play this. He does. Brummett will collect. Behind the Warriors' net. Looks for an outlet pass, and it's not you, Chris. That drum's definitely got louder this second period. Good save, Josh Nichols, though.
Good save by Josh Nichols, and hopefully that will repair a little bit of the confidence from that last goal that you just let in.
I am still trying to work out how that one snuck through. I think he thought he
I'm
had it.
I'm pretty sure when we review the replay when we're on the bus on the way back, we'll be certain of how it got in.
Meanwhile, though, the game goes on, and Nichols will pad that behind the net. That's brave play. Leg guard. And the boards. It's still free. Shot, and that's wide. Blaze getting away with one there. Didn't see who it was. Three in front of the net may have been Robinson. Ryan Sample, first we've seen of him tonight, behind the net. Beats Gareth Owen, shot. Nichols has to hold on. Puck still free in front of him eventually. The puck ricochets up off the roof. If Gareth Owen can get to that, there may be the chance of a breakaway. Ali Brummett is playing it, and he's checked into the boards by Owen. That's a little bit annoyed. He didn't manage to get to that. Kieran Papps now. 13:59 remaining in this second period. 3-2 Whitley Warriors. Philip Pollock, though, tries to get a shot off. Doesn't manage to. Hubbard will go and try and collect that behind the net, but Williams. It looks like Reg Wilcox has changed the lines up again, Chris.
Again, Tom P's playing really deep, just losing the puck there. And now there'll be a hooking call.
Looks another like another Whitley penalty.
It is. It's going to be Paul Windridge.
Indeed, for hooking.
Someone who in the last two, in this game and the game yesterday, spent a lot of time in the penalty box.
It's a useful little agitator at this level, Paul Windridge. 13:37 remaining now in this second period.
And it's hooking.
And it was indeed hooking. So Blaze get another power play.
So McWilliams, Owen, Ledgard, Kovacka and Kieran Papps.
It is the big guns. The two cannons from the point, Papps and Kovacka. Papps feeds Kovacka over the far side. Shot, nearly sneaks through. Squirted out in front. Kovacka, Papps, sorry, nearly got to that one. And suddenly, Gareth Owen has to back check. He does. Good back checking, Gareth Owen. That's offside as well.
And you said yesterday, Gareth Owen doesn't know the meaning of the word quit, and we just saw it there.
Skating from behind the Whitley goal just then back check in.
Sorry, Paul. No Blaze worries. Really do need to watch this. They keep getting caught on these cross-ice passes at the point, and the Warriors are just getting a breakaway almost every time. They need to work out something different earlier and lower down in the zone.
They've still got plenty of time. There's only 20 seconds gone on the power play. And less than half the game gone. One goal in it. Blaze need to get two in order to take it to overtime. If the Warriors don't score again. Perhaps can't find it. And the puck is jammed down in front of the Blaze bench, in front of us. Owen, that's a good pass. Kovacka gets a shot off. Owen nearly tips that one in.
And if only that had been on the right side for Kovacka, he'd have been able to get a shot straight off.
Perhaps tries to get a shot. It's blocked, though. Minute gone on this power play opportunity. That's offside as well. We'll see if the face-off takes place just outside the zone or goes all the way back.
I think it was Ross Venus had just come off the bench and a little bit too early. And the way the benches are designed here, you come off the bench and you're pretty much in the opposition's own end immediately.
Have to be very careful to cross on the right side of the blue line when you change. I remember when I played here a couple of years ago, you had a good 3 or 4 foot drop down onto the ice off the benches because they were raised to the level of the walkway. The rink here is in something of a depression. Here comes Venus, trying to lift the Blaze fans' depression. And Hubbock over the far side. Venus again. Hubbock fights his way through. Venus tries those fancy hands of him.
He needs to pass earlier. He can't keep doing that. They've worked out what he's about.
Eventually gets one through. Flavelle has to hold on with Nicklin waiting. But that shot from the point from James Pease, easily dealt with by Whitley's goalie. 21 seconds remaining on the power play. 11:57 remaining in the second period of this game.
And with 21 seconds left on that power play, Reg has sent out his face-off winner, Mr. Michael Stevenson.
See if he can win it and let the Blaze set up. Tom and James Pease at the point. It goes back to James Pease, who can't keep it in. James Pease cruises back a little, feeds Venus. Nice hands across Venus, beats the first man, gets a shot off. Lavelle blocks it, it's still free. Score! ENL Blaze! I didn't see who got the final touch. I think it was McWilliams again.
I believe it was. I believe it may have been the trash man, McWilliams.
Shot from Venus, off the rebound, and reached McWilliams on the power play. picks it up, snaffles it up, and just gleefully bangs it home.
Well, no, it won't have been Reece McWilliams. Reece McWilliams is on the bench.
It was Stevenson.
There we go.
They both wear black helmets. That's what it was.
So Stevenson with a dig for victory goal.
So Michael Stevenson getting the third goal. And once again,
it's a one-goal game.
Indeed, the ENL Blaze have equalised. One-goal tie. James Pease getting one of the assists. Ross Venus getting the other. Michael Stevenson scoring it. So, Blaze's power play gets them back into the game.
But that goal was all Ross Venus. That was the hard work with the stick handling from the corner.
Pollock plays it across. No one can get to it, though. Gareth Owen will go over and collect it behind the net. Hubbard waits. Owen goes for the wraparound. It's blocked, though, by the pursuing defenseman. Still going, Gareth Owen. And Favell sprawls to block it. The Warriors fans panicking a little. They know this tie is by no means over.
ENL stepping up the tempo once again and riding the momentum.
And the Blaze fans responding over to our left. Drums from both sides. We're getting drums in stereo here. Selwood plays it out of the zone. Leg guard will chase. He'll block that leg guard. Still in the zone, needs support. But Williams backing him up. That's good work from Tom Leggard on the forecheck to keep the puck in the zone. Williams will cycle it. Leggard tries to play it across the ice, doesn't manage to though. Puck goes back into the zone and out again.
Tom Leggard's currently back on defence, covering, I believe, for Ryan Selwood.
He is Selwood now working his way back. Puck is on the opposite side. Space for Leggard to skate into now. Winds one up, shot from Leggard from a long way out. Favell has to pat it wide.
I thought that was going in.
I did wonder. The perspective we've got up here made it look like that had ricocheted into the top corner of James Favell's net for a second. Now, pass. Daniel Good can't find it under his feet. I'm amazed he didn't get levelled then. Blaze defenseman would have been well within their rights to step up and flatten Daniel Good.
That's beautiful non-quitting work there by Ross Venus. He was on the floor, but he just kept his stick active.
Watson will chase that, but it'll be icing. Josh Nichols will collect it. So, 30 minutes and 15 seconds gone in the second leg. We are three quarters of the way through the ENL North playoff final. Whitley Warriors with a narrow one-goal advantage on aggregate at the moment. It's 3-3 on the night. And 6-5 on aggregate to the Warriors. They'll get chased into the corner. The Warriors will bring that one out with Watson. Daniel Good tries to break his way through. Doesn't manage to, though. And the puck played back down for Ali Brummett in his own zone, who can only find Stevenson. There's a whistle, though, as Pinyarski wasn't out the zone quickly enough. Referee Emerson has decided that's intentional offside, so the puck will travel all the way back down to the Blaze zone. Possibly a little harsh, I think.
Possibly a little harsh. It's very hard to tell. I mean, offside looks offside to me. And we've been able really to differentiate between the two.
I think Ricky Pinyarski was trying to get out the zone, just didn't get out the zone quick enough, perhaps, there. Either way, the face-off will take place to Josh Nichols' left. And will be won by the Blaze. Pinyarski will chase that one down, as he always does. He's still going, Mickey Pinyarski, the puck behind the Warriors' net from a face-off in the Blaze defensive zone. Good play by Pinyarski chasing that one down. He's still going behind the net. However, the Warriors eventually win that puck. And Kippen will come up the ice.
Warriors definitely doing what they do best, which is using their bodies and using that physical style of play to shut down the Blaze offense.
They have got a style of play which seems tailored to rinks like this. Pollock fakes a shot. He's flattened at center ice by, I think that was Ajak. Possibly Ryan Sample. Just steps up and goes straight through Philip Pollock perfectly cleanly.
And that was a hit and a half on Philip Pollock. I don't think he saw it, but that's what happens when you enter the zone and you've got your eyes mainly on the puck.
And Emerson's called that. I am frankly amazed. That looked perfectly clean to me. It was Daniel Good, in fact. Not Ryan Sample.
Well, I don't know. Maybe it's just Emerson sending a signal that calm it down, boys, before someone gets hurt. From my perspective, I know I said impartiality out the window, but it did look a little bit like the shoulder was coming down. In that.
Either way, Blaze are on the power play again. They scored on the last power play.
And he's given 2 minutes for elbows.
That's a curious one. I thought the shoulder collided. The Warriors fans certainly aren't happy with it. By the way, the Blaze are on the power play. And don't forget, one goal for the Blaze at the current state of play would bring the team's level on aggregate. Owen. Across the boards to Leggard. Owen again. Played across. Tom Pease wants a shot. Leggard shoots and Flavel throws himself acrobatically across his net.
The puck was literally rolling across his stomach.
Now Tom Pease, James Pease, eventually dumps it into the zone.
I think it's a bit of a, that call from Emerson, it's a bit of a grey area to call with elbows, because even though it is the shoulder coming down, I believe it's classed between the elbow and the shoulder, as if it's an elbow.
Ross Venus stick handling again through centre ice. Still going, Ross Venus, he shoots. Good save, James Favell. Had to be alert there. That was a hard shot from Venus. Got his tail up a bit, the young Blaze winger. Here is Tom Pease. Tries to get a shot through. However, James Pease picks it up at the point and shoots it free in front of the net again. They're digging away, the Blaze. Venus eventually ends up on top of Favell, along with about three Warriors.
Well, that was good rebound control work by the Warriors there, but the ENL Blaze doing what Paul Thompson said they should do yesterday, using the screen.
7:19 remaining in this second period. 3-3 on the night. 6-5 to the Whitley Warriors on aggregate. And the ENL Blaze have just under 30 seconds remaining on this power play. Penalty to Daniel Good for elbows.
Most of this period has seemed like a power play, really, for the ENL Blaze. They've had most of the pressure.
That sneaks through. Nichols will have to cover that one up. He does. He's snowed by Adam Reynolds. I think we can give Reynolds that one because he had to stop pretty quickly. Otherwise, he'd have gone straight over Josh Nichols and into the back of the net. Face-off to Nichols' left.
Well, you and I being Coventry fans, we know all about in the crease goalie incidents this year.
Seen plenty of them. And also beforehand as well, we've seen lots from Marty Klemper when he played in Coventry.
Well, that was before my time in Coventry, I'm afraid.
But Brett Yeager, Alex Penner of Nottingham falling upon Brett Yeager on several occasions and indeed eventually sparking a bench clearance indirectly. Flavel, Whitley returned to full strength. Meanwhile, Reynolds will hold that up against the boards. He's pressured by Nicklin. Owen. Eventually goes acrobatically forward, rolls over the top of the Whitley player. And now Daniel Good out of the box in space. Daniel Good, if he squares it, it's a goal. And there we go. Tipped in by Adam Reynolds.
Well, there was nothing Antti Kovacka could do in that situation. He did what he thought was best, which was put his body down to try and cover the puck as it came across. But Daniel Good was able to square it quicker than he was able to get the body down.
I think that was Adam Reynolds who tipped that in. We'll confirm who tipped it in shortly. It may have also been Callum Watson. The Whitley numbers very hard to make out in the Lightning from up here. Once again, it's a two-goal game from the ENL Blaze perspective. Nothing else will do. It is Adam Reynolds. Tips in a Daniel Good pass.
And so, once again, the mountain just keeps getting higher and higher.
But the Blaze are hanging in, and here they go again. A ricochet, Gavithone will get across to that. And he will play it across. There's all sorts of holding going on. Eventually, the Blaze still trying to fight their way through.
And Emerson looking right at Gareth Owen being practically hugged in the Warrior end and doing nothing about it.
That is, at best, a curious call from Mr. Emerson.
Possibly that's Mr. Emerson admitting that he made a mistake down the other end with the elbowing call, and now he's letting it go.
Gareth Owen still trying to work out how there was no penalty on Daniel Harris on that play.
That was practically a wrestling match going on down there.
Face off.
Emerson should have been
the zone.
Emerson should have been down on the ice counting 1, 2, 3.
I think that was Daniel Harris going for the pin then. But Williams will go for the face off along with Daniel Good though. Whitley will win it. And it's forced against the boards, but Williams nearly manages to pull the puck in. He eventually manages to lay it off. Venus takes it with him eventually. Shot from leg guard. Flavelle just pads that up in the air. And but Williams gets a glove in the face. Fights his way free eventually.
You know what? I never thought I'd say this, but I want Blaine Evans.
There's a few seconds of silence. I'm in shock. Meanwhile, McWilliams tries to feed Venus. Doesn't manage to. Leg guard, though. Has a bit of space. That's a superb block. I didn't see who slid then. I think it was Callum Watson who threw himself full length to block. Leg guard's attempted shot. And Whitley in the zone again. 3-on-2. Shot. Nichols spreads himself somehow. The puck stays out. And the Blaze leave to fight another day. Here's Josh Nicklin. Flavelle can't hold on to it.
And the chance of dodgy keeper from the Warriors fans comes back to haunt them for a second there.
Indeed, somewhat ironic they do that just as Flavelle juggles the puck. Nichols, eventually the puck comes to a Blaze player. Vinyarski crosses the red line. Feeds Nicklin. Nicklin gets a weak shot off on net. I don't think he could have done much else in fairness to him. Vinyarski trying to cycle the puck.
And again, that's holding and hooking right there.
And still, I'm amazed Nicklin's able to stay on his feet with being yanked
that's
all over
Vinyarski
the place.
That's Vinyarski being yanked all over the place. And I'm getting some looks here, but that is holding if you've got your arm around the player's waist.
Indeed, Vinyarski in a bit of space.
To you, sir, looking at me in front of us.
Eventually manages to fight free of the hook shot. And Nichols holds on to that one.
And that doesn't exactly look like the save of a dodgy keeper right there.
Indeed, he just flicks his glove hand out there. Makes the save. Mr. Emerson has made some questionable calls on both sides this period. It's got to be said, Daniel Good's call for elbowing was somewhat curious. But how he's managed to miss several wrestling matches. You've got to think that he's trying to compensate perhaps a bit too much for that one dodgy call.
Are we at the ENL playoff final or WrestleMania?
I thought it was more Greco-Roman the way things were going. Lots of throws going up. Now the puck. Dump on the balls. Hubbock will get to that. And the ENL Blaze have to fight their way out their own end. We're coming to the closing stages of the second period. 3 minutes 30 left. Put behind the net. Nichols spreads himself to try and prevent the wraparound. That's good play by Adam Reynolds, though.
That's good work by Josh Nichols, just trying to cover on the wraparound.
Eventually, the puck works its way through the zone, and the Blaze can cross the red line. Gareth Owen gets into the zone, dumps it round for Philip Pollock to chase. Pollock puts in a soft hit, bit of a shove. Fairness to Pollock, he had to pull out of that one. And that's dumped down the ice. Doesn't go very far, though. Owen into the zone, shoots Gareth Owen. Flavelle drops it, and the puck bobbles up.
And
luckily
James
for James Flavelle.
Extremely lucky James Flavelle there, once again bobbling the puck.
I think if that had dropped to the ice, Owen would have gleefully banged that one home. The ENL Blaze offside there. Gareth Owen goes head first into the bench. And Sample, mishandling the puck in his own end, gets very lucky.
Tom Leggard, unfortunately, very unlucky there. Just caught out by his own momentum, really, as he was skating through.
Indeed, Sample was very calm then, considering it. And he goes in fast and hard at the other end, Ryan Sample. I think you can see that hit coming. He might as well have sent a postcard warning Venus he was coming.
That was Selwood he hit.
It's the lighting. Oh, superb drop pass for Williams. Venus shoots. It's a good save, though. Clavel. And occasionally you get flashes of inspiration like that, which show that this game isn't over for the ENL Blaze. Don't forget,
it's a long
they
way
only
to
need
go.
2 goals.
20 minutes is a lot. Well, 21 minutes and 46 seconds is a long time in hockey.
Here
a
is Vinyarski. Winds one up straight into the pads of Ali Brummett. And suddenly, as we say that, shot goes the other way. It goes wide, though. And worrying times at both ends for both teams. Both goalies need to be alert here. Puck eventually nearly finds Carl Colley in front of the net. Tom Pease has to go to that, he does. So eventually cleared out of the zone. That'll be icing. So, it's as you were at the end of the first period at the moment, 4-3.
Whitley Warriors doing a superb job here at the moment to preserve that two-goal lead they established in the first period.
The score on aggregate is 7-5 at the moment.
Blaze just unable to get that little bit extra to just put them over the edge. They get back within reaching distance and then, unfortunately, everything goes against them.
Puck goes back to the point shot. It goes just wide. Nichols has to spread himself. Binyarski has a bit of space to skate into, being hustled hard by several back checkers, Watson included. Binyarski shoots on the net, doesn't manage to square it across. He's hit high, Binyarski. Goes into the balls backwards, has to get out the zone now. Goes for a change.
I think that one knocked the wind out of him.
He looked like he felt that one. It was a very hard check indeed.
Well, it's a good game plan here at the moment by the Warriors to knock the star players for the Blaze out by hitting them like there's no tomorrow.
Should be said, though, the Warriors hitting hard and for the most part clean. Nichols very nearly lets that one through him. The puck is down the ice, though. That will be icing. 25 seconds remaining in this period. And thoughts, obviously, will turn to the beginning of the third period. And team talks, if you're in the locker room for the ENL Blaze, Chris, what do you say?
Well, the D-men at the point need to watch where they're passing it and also watch on their control. And the forwards really do need to get on the end of those rebounds. Somebody really needs to get into a position to control them.
Shot, and again, blocked. As you say that, the defence clearing the puck out in front of Josh Nichols, Whitley firing several shots.
You see it there, they are a perfect example from the Warriors. They had three players all in the house waiting to jump on that rebound. If you've got players in the house, you'll get the rebounds and you have opportunities to score.
That puck is dumped down the ice. It'll be icing again. Into the final 3.5 seconds of this second period. 4-3, favour of the Whitley Warriors. In the second leg of this ENL North playoff final. Up here in the historic old rink of Whitley Bay. And the face-off will simply sit there. That'll be the whistle at the end of the second. Advantage Whitley, you've got to say.
Definitely advantage Whitley. They're on the momentum at the moment, as we saw at the end of the period there.
So, the ENL Blaze have 20 minutes to save their season, effectively. If they win this, they will go forward to the ENL playoff final against Chelmsford Chieftains, but obviously, I'm looking ahead more in hope than expectation at the moment, with 20 minutes left.
Well, the weird thing is, we did mention earlier when we were off during the break about how we were afraid we were seeing history possibly repeating itself from yesterday. Yesterday, Blaze had a good first period. They had a not-so-good second period, which they've had today, and then they had an amazing third period.
Indeed, and they scored two unanswered goals as well in the third period. Yep. So we can, of course, hope for that to happen again. That would do very nicely for Blaze fans.
I
that would
right,
make it level on aggregate.
Right now, if I was Reg Wilcox, I would be aiming for get the two goals you need to tie this up and then think about pushing on for the win.
They don't believe in doing things easy, the ENL Blaze. They got here after penalties over two legs against Nottingham Lions. 5-5 on aggregate, and they eventually got to a momentous penalty shootout. We'll see what happens in the third period. We'll be back here with that in about 10 minutes or so.